Da, mulțumesc foarte mult. Am revenit cu domnul Alexandru Rușandu, Global Security Services Head of Portfolio and Service Engineering from Atos IT Solutions and Services. O intervenție, Alexandru, despre trends și megatrends, corect?
Da. Bună ziua, bine v-am găsit, mulțumesc pentru oportunitate. O să încerc să vorbesc astăzi despre trends, ce se va întâmpla în 2021, dar also, o să schimb puțin în engleză, also beyond that. So, what the future holds? We need to build trust to control the access to data, but also we need to build trust to secure the use of data. Data is pervasive, identity is the new perimeter, and permission are the new attack surface. API is the new single point of failure. Encryption will never fail you if it's applicable correctly. What we need also is use of AI automation for an adaptive security. Now, talking about the trends and beyond that, I highlight five chapters, very important in my view. The first one, advanced detection and response. What we need here and what I'm seeing a managed extension detection and response, extended detection and response. I'm seeing API security detection and response. I'm seeing a lot of needs for machine learning detection and response, threat anticipation, attack prediction, but also the need to implement AI algorithms for business-specific use case for detection, like for industries, for example, for automotive, for media, for manufacturing. But also we need an AI platform for cybersecurity analytics, detection and response, of course, and a hybrid SecOps model. The AI for cybersecurity is very, very important in this area with deep learning, federated learning, and frugal learning. Detect framework, which is composed of the tech framework alignment with MITRE attacks framework and React response framework. But further than that, and beyond 2021, what we need is quantum AI and security for AI. Moving to the cloud for se cloud security, what we need and what I'm seeing is a lot of unified cyber posture management and access management. I'm seeing container and auto-containment for data security. I'm seeing security as a code, serverless security, application security analytics, application shielding, but also continuous compliance and recovery. Very important self-healing, also cloud infrastructure and entitlements management. Talking about the next one, zero trust security, very popular. Everybody's talking about the zero trust. What actually means, do not trust anybody, always verify. The COVID-19 situation pushed the employee outside of the control of the corporate land perimeter. It's an actual accelerator for the zero trust adoption.
Alex, în caz că ai vreun slide, să știi că nu este șerat.
Serios? Oh, îmi cer scuze. Ok.
Și fă-l mare, te rog, dacă poți.
Ok.
Excellent. Thank you.
Scuze eu. Discutând despre back to English, talking about the zero trust security, which never trust anybody, always verify. The COVID-19 situation pushed the employee outside of the control of the corporate land perimeter, according to Forrester. The identity segmentation, people, device, entities, anywhere, they need access to resources everywhere. The zero trust access and password authentication is also needed. Secure access service edge, or AKA called SASE, it's something that definitely we need to adopt. Micro-segmentation, where reducing the attack surface is important, improve the breach containment, strong regulation and compliance and streamline the policy management. Data security, it's the fourth one where I'm seeing data protection blockchain for and distributed ledger for data security, for API, for defense, for identity management, for transportation and supply chain. Cyber resilience, data security operation, or data SecOps is the new thing here. Autonomous privacy impact assessment and ethical machines. The digital risk protection is also extremely and very important with digital surveillance services, digital footprint, brand protection, and risk mitigation. The IoT chapter with convergence of the IoT world, OT world, the old dino that is dying slowly, and together with industrial IoT, we need 360-degree visibility. We have a lot of IP communication within this convergence. We need cyber resilience and we need cyber protection. A lot of APIs, you can imagine that a lot of APIs are there, and we need adaptive cyber protection and resilience. The IoT access control is something additional that we need. We need to control, to be able to control the access of the data, as commented earlier, and we need to build the trust in order to secure the use of data. Very important also, I would like to highlight, is the cooperative intelligence transport system, or called C-ITC security. The security here, you can imagine that there is a lot of data exchange there, right? Talking about awareness driving, sensing driving, and cooperative driving, where human life is at stake. We need to control the traffic, the use of data. We need cyber resilience. We need protection. It's imperative by design. The edge computing security is also one of the sub-chapter here, where edge devices need security orchestrator. We need distributed cloud security, security at the edge, and cloudless also. Cyber resilience and protection is extremely important. Imagine a situation, a military or in defense, where you are using the power of edge or you are using the cloudless. It's extremely important to secure by design, to be secure by design, to have the necessary resilience and protection there. I need to apologize again for not sharing from the beginning the presentation. I thought I did, but this is life. We learn from mistakes. That's all from my side.
Thank you very much, Alex. It's a very comprehensive approach in the presentation about how the future will look like. I've seen inside, and it catch a little bit the attention, quantum AI, quantum artificial intelligence. What can you detail a little bit? What could be this trend in the future?
Well, we all know that the computer power is evolving. We all know that at the moment it's not enough. We are talking about, for example, in encryption as a last defense in an organization. And we'll never fail you until you have enough computer power to breach that or to break the algorithm, right? Now, if you're watching all the white papers over different organizations, even Atos, we are investing a lot in quantum computing. Quantum computing is the next generation of a computer calculation and power. And talking about beyond, meaning what the future holds, it's how to apply the quantum power with the AI. But very, very close to that, or let's say together with that, it's very important, the last point that I mentioned, the security for the AI. Imagine what will happen if you have a last generation quantum AI solving a lot of problems and doing detection or threat anticipation, threat prediction, where your customer environment it's not only protected, but you anticipate where he can be attacked, and you can anticipate the motive behind the well-organized criminals. Imagine they will try to attack you, and where they will try to attack you, the AI, the power behind it, right? So we will need quantum AI in order to increase our power, our computer calculation. But also we need the security for the AI. And that's why I put it the last one. And also very, very important, if you are watching the latest news, you are see that technology, I mean, the corporation or the humankind is investing a lot in technology. Technology can be one of the tools for us to be, let's say, to have a better world, right? Talking about the decarbonization, but talking about solving, for example, or finding a better solution for pandemics. But also, don't think that we are only us, meaning the cybersecurity, the good part of the cybersecurity will be using the quantum and the power of calculation. Definitely, there is also the cyber criminal organization, very funded, very good funded. They have a lot of money. The government, some government like North Korea, apologize for saying that, but this is the reality, that they're putting a lot of money in cyber criminal organization. They will invest in quantum AI. They will invest in quantum AI in the way that in order to breach something, to steal something, to get in to our most guarded secret.
Thank you very much. As far as I know, North Korea has a lot of income which comes from ransomware as a percentage for the GDP, for the revenues. Alex, thank you very much. Thank you again, Atos, for being with us, and keep in touch. Thank you.
Bye.